guys, welcome back to another video. So this video is going to be all about my taper and then also my carb load, and at the end I will show you the expo as well, which was honestly the most exciting thing, okay, other than race day, but it was so exciting to go to. So during the taper, I did decrease my overall volume, but I did keep intensity relatively high. Lower than usual, but relatively high. So I did continue boxing training, but I did reduce the amount of sessions within the week, and I did also just listen to my body and kind of took it easy when I felt like it, but I did continue to do boxing. I also continued to do strength training, and I had lined up my deload week to be in the same week as my taper. So the overall volume of my strength training was lower, and the intensity of my strength training was lower as well. So I did two upper body sessions and two lower body sessions within the week. And then I did keep speed runs in there. My last high intensity speed run was 5 days before the race. And the overall mileage of that speed run was lower than my previous speed running sessions, as well as the intensity of that specific speed run was lower than usual. But the reason that you lower your overall volume of training is because you're not going to be producing any more mitochondria than usual, but you can keep the intensity in there because you have built up all of this mitochondrial density, but you want to keep them functioning optimally. And that is why you keep some intensity sessions in there, but you decrease your overall volume to allow your legs to rest and recover so that you can perform optimally on race day. My long run session, in quotation marks, was only 6K long, and that was 7 days before race day.
Okay, so I am on my way now to go get, so I'm going to the expo and I'm going to get my race pack and register and do all that, and then have a look around at all the little stores and everything. I am actually so excited for this now. Wow. It is like the last 2 weeks I have been so like lethargic and just felt tired. You feel like you're losing fitness and all this stuff. Like, from what I know about a taper and studying athletes and you're studying periodization and everything, I know that in a taper usually you feel worse than what you do feel like in peak week or in the weeks leading up to it when you're training hard and everything, because you feel this intense mental fatigue, and because you're doing less you feel like you're losing fitness. And I think as well, if you are someone who exercises a lot, exercise can almost be a bit of an outlet, or your body is also very, very used to it and used to moving, and that's how it operates at its best. Whereas now you're not moving as much, or you're doing lower intensity stuff, so you just don't feel yourself. I was just feeling like this mental fatigue and lethargic and just not my best. But then I would feel my best when I was running, which is absolutely, it's the weirdest concept. Anyway, so I did a speed run in the early half of last week, and I was feeling so great during that time and everything. And then I went to my physio had, I had some needling done in my back and shoulders, and just everything was like tight. And that was on the Wednesday. And then the second half of the week, I was just not wanting to run. Honestly, I was like, how am I going to do this? I'm losing fitness. I haven't, well, I didn't, I knew I wasn't, because I know the science behind it. That's the thing. But you feel, oh, it's so hard to explain if you haven't done a taper. But then after I would do like a short run, say like 5K or 6K or something, I would feel so much better while I was running, and off, like just after the run, I would feel on top of the world. So it's weird how you feel better running than not running, which is exactly what you want, I guess. Tomorrow I have a, they call it, it's typically called a shakeout run. Very short. It's only, if you're doing a hot, even a marathon, it's only about 5K. So I'm only going to do about 3K tomorrow, 3-4K, just to shake out the legs. Yesterday was the first day of carb loading. So how I've been carb loading, I've done 6 grams per kilogram of body weight on the first day. Then I moved up to, but I usually have a very high carb, I have more carbs than fats in my diet anyway, for the ratio of calories. But so I did, and I did 7 grams per kilogram of body weight yesterday. Today I move closer to 8 grams per kilogram of body weight, and then tomorrow I move closer to 9, and then the morning of, I'm having some carbs before, 2 hours before the run, I'm planning to eat a good meal, like oats. People usually have oats or an English muffin or something with honey and that kind of thing. And then, but wow, since yesterday, like today's the first day that I'm actually feeling so excited. Oh, I'm driving past the finish line right now. That is exciting. On the UCT fields, that's where we end, and I can literally see the finish line. And today I drove through the starting line outside CESA. Anyway, so after yesterday and all this rest and everything, today I'm literally feeling like agitated, like I want to run, I want to move, which is exactly what you want. And this is the second day of carb loading. And then yeah, tomorrow is just a shake-up run. And this morning I went to boxing, but I really just held myself back, didn't do anything too intense. The reason I move up each day in grams per kilogram of body weight, I just prefer to do it that way because it's easier on my digestive system, for one. Secondly, I feel like it saturates into my muscles and saturates my glycogen, fills up my glycogen stores better that way, just from how I've practiced before. So that's why I'm moving up slowly, but you can definitely jump up to however many carbohydrates you want for the 3 days before. And usually you aim for between 6 to 12 grams per kilogram of body weight. It's 6 to 12 if it's 3 days before. The closer, if you're only doing like a 1 day carb load, which I wouldn't recommend, but if you are doing that, like just the day before, then you literally have to have like 12 grams per kilogram, and that's a lot of carbs, especially because you don't want like creamy like pastas and pizza with sauces and cheese and fatty things, because that's hard on your digestion and that's not going to help you at all. So it's all from good sources.
Yeah.
Of, it's pretty much like clean foods. So, yeah.
It was so fun, actually, just like walking around. It was such a good vibe. Like, I was so hyped afterwards. I was fully like, I don't know, I was so excited. Anyway, so we got this race bag to Ocean's Half Marathon, and then we got this, which I folded up. So in this envelope, basically just my race number. There's two copies. A front and back. Oh, I need to flatten this out. But so this is my race number. I'm so excited. So P is my start time. I start at 6:56. And so there's two, one for the front and one for the back. And then we got this race bag. So I bought a bunch of stuff at the expo as well. So I'll show you everything that I bought, but I'm going to show you first what was in the race pack. It really isn't that exciting. I mean, oh, yay. Whole grain rice, if anyone wanted. Some deodorant, because everyone needs deodorant in their life. Some green tea. Which is great. And then Tic Tacs. Yay, we love Tic Tacs. And then I also obviously got my Two Oceans shirt. Aww. It's actually so nice. And then, so that's the front, and then this is the back. I might wear it, I'll see. And then I bought a bunch of stuff. So I actually got a hydration, one of those, I think in a video earlier, I think in my long run video, I was like, I want to get like a race pack thing. But then you would have probably seen in one of my other, I think my peak week vlog, that I actually got a hydration pack. But I was an idiot and didn't get water bottles. So I bought water bottles for them. So I bought two. They're each 500 mils. And then one I'll have electrolytes and glucose, a glucose drink in there. And then another one, maybe water. And then I got these hydration electrolyte tablets from Goo. It's the strawberry lemonade flavor, and they are 320 milligrams of sodium per serving, no caffeine. And then I also got these electrolyte tablets, the capsules, just because I think after this, like the biggest, I've noticed such an improvement in my overall performance, even in boxing and strength training, just when I've had electrolytes, and it's made me realize how important they are just in training, and especially if you're training a lot. And I definitely wasn't having that because I do eat a like healthy diet, So I, yeah, just realized I wasn't having enough. Anyway, so I'm going to use these as well. They're just electrolyte capsules. So gosh, I really liked these chews. So I like to have those in my runs. And then the last two things, I think I might actually wear this. It's a running top, just plain black. Just a nice running top, and it's literally temperature regulated, so it keeps you really warm or cools you down. And then I also got a white one. So yeah, I might wear the black one on the day, or the t-shirt. I'm not sure, because it's going to be so cold in the morning, but I'm so happy with everything, and I'm so excited for this thing. It was honestly just such a fun experience. But yeah, I will update you tomorrow on how I'm feeling before the race. And then it is race day, or race morning. Yeah, I don't know how much sleep I'll be getting. Probably nothing the night before. But more carb loading tomorrow. Anyway, I'm excited. So that was such a vibe. I loved that.